Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Vivian, and as you saw in my intro, I do all kinds of videos, all things lifestyle, vlogs, beauty, fashion, all sorts of things. So if you're interested in all those kind of things and my French bulldogs, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below so you don't miss out on my future videos. Okay, so today is a totally different kind of video, and I'm hoping to make it through without any type of tears or anything. I should be okay because it's been a few weeks since this whole traumatic event happened to our French bulldog Claude, and we're kind of through the worst of it. But just a heads up, this video is not for the faint of heart. I will probably get into a couple graphic things to show you kind of the steps that Claude went through and what his eye looked like during the event. And what I'm basically talking about is, unfortunately, our French bulldog, who is now going to be 14 years old, he's 13, and he's sitting right here next to me, he had his left eye removed. And it is what we call an enucleation. And basically he had an ulcer in his eye that was caused by something. We're not sure what. Usually when this type of thing happens, it's some sort of a traumatic event. I don't know if he hit himself with something, or if he landed, on a toy, or if Elvis, our other French bulldog, may have, you know, swatted him in the eye with his paw and his nail. I don't know. The vet said he could have rubbed it into the carpet and caused it. He's always had a little bit of eye problems. French bulldogs have very bulgy eyes, and so it can be more problematic for them to have eye problems and ulcers and issues getting things in their eye and things like that. So we're not quite sure how it happened, but he had some sort of traumatic event happen and it punctured his cornea. And so he was basically squinting, and this all happened within a period of about 48 hours that we noticed it. Like last year he had some eye problems, and so we had some antibiotics, and so we started putting those in his eyes after calling the vet, and they said, well, try the antibiotic drops that you have for a couple days and just see how that works. Well, by the third day he was not doing well. He was squinting all the time, and if you went anywhere near him he would squirm. He didn't like to be touched. So I made an emergency vet appointment and got him in, and they basically said they had to remove his eye. It was horrible. We basically broke down. He's 13 years old. He's already deaf. He's already had some issues with urination. He's starting to leak. And so we really, she said, you either have to remove the eye or put him down. And so at that point, you're left with that decision. And we were just not ready to put him down. He's still active for the most part. He still likes to play on occasion with his brother. Hi. He's sitting right here with me today. He still loves to eat. He still loves his treats. He still moves around. He's not laying in a bed like 24/7. He's still active. So we did decide to go ahead and do the enucleation of his eye. Basically what an enucleation is, and I wrote some notes down just so I wouldn't forget. It is the surgical removal of the eyeball. And it sounds really horrific. And when she told us what she was going to go do or what she had to do, it just sounded horrific. But the dogs do adapt well. We were pretty shocked, and we are shocked at how well he's adapted, even being the age that he is, and being able to function with just the one eye. It's just pretty amazing. Obviously this was a last resort in our case. I think that, like the vet said, if you catch an ulcer, because that's what it basically is an ulcer, if you catch it early enough, they could treat it. With him though, she said it just wasn't even an option. Elvis wanted to join now as well. He has to be the star of the show. This is Elvis. If you guys are new to my channel, these guys definitely make appearances every once in a while. And so here they are today. No. It's funny how dogs kind of know, I think, when there's an issue and when there's something wrong with another fellow family dog. Elvis really just like wanted to sniff him and see what was going on, and kind of left him alone for the most part. So we're basically watching him very closely, but I'll be inserting some other videos here so you guys can see kind of what we went through with him. So the day that he was going to have the surgery, she said it would probably take about an hour or two at the most, and they were going to completely remove his eye and then stitch up the eye socket. And at that point, you know, him being 13 years old and being a French bulldog, we know he, through anesthesia, sometimes they don't make it. We just basically went back and said our goodbyes just in case. And they sent us home because they were going to have to keep him overnight anyway. And it was already like 6 o'clock at night when this all happened. So they did the surgery. They called us probably around 8 o'clock or so and just let us know that the surgery went well and that he did come out of it, but they're just going to monitor him. So, and then we could come and pick him up the following morning. And when we picked him up, he was wearing this lovely little cone, which I will show here, which was horribly like uncomfortable in my opinion. It's a big plastic Elizabethan cone that obviously most of you who have had dogs and have had any type of surgeries usually have to wear. And so they kind of showed us, you know, how to remove it, and you basically just have to pull it on and off, and that just wasn't gonna fly for me. It was quite large, quite uncomfortable in my opinion. Okay, so this is the collar that he originally came home with, and it's just very plasticky and you can't really take it apart. You actually have to like pull it off his head, and I just didn't like any part of that at all. He had to wear this, according to the vet, 24/7 unless he was like eating or something. So I just couldn't even have imagined him having to be wearing this all the time. So I went ahead and purchased this. And this one's nicer because it actually Velcros on and off, so I didn't have to pull it out over his head, because you had to like basically like pull it right past that eye, which had all the stitches, and that just, I'm sorry, I just couldn't do it. So this one is adjustable. I did buy the medium size, which is for the neck size, 12 inches to 16 inches, and here is the box. If I can find this, I will link it down below, because I really think this is awesome for you guys to have on hand. I will be keeping this in case Elvis ever needs to have surgery. You can reuse it, obviously. You can wash it. The Calm Paws Behavior Support Premium Soft E-Collar for Dogs. And it's the Caring Collar with Calming Gel Patch. I didn't use the gel patch. I don't think I needed to use that. But there is like a little gel patch that's like lavender scented or something that you can basically insert in here. Just probably gives them some calming smells or whatever. But as you can see, it's got just some really nice material here, which is usually where I ended up laying his head, which is probably right about here. And it did get pretty dirty, so after a couple days I did go ahead and wash it, and then I just laid it flat to dry, so it would dry pretty quickly, so he would only be off of it for maybe like an hour and 15 minutes, and then we'd be monitoring him to make sure he wasn't, you know, hitting his eye up against a wall or anything like that, which is what they're really worried about, is that he might damage the stitches, or that the stitches might come out. So we did keep him in it for 2 weeks, which was really, really hard. After the surgery, he had some pain medication and some antibiotics, and that was pretty much it. So he's already on a thyroid medication. He's already on a skin medication. He didn't act like he was in pain or anything, so whatever pain medication it was, I don't remember what it was called, I think worked very well for him. It was quite a horrible 2 week adjustment period for all of us, including Claude. But this really made things a lot easier for us, and I think more manageable for him, more comfortable for him. I really like it. So this video is in no way sponsored by anyone. I'm just letting you know what I found through the pet store and what I was able to come up with. Really did think this was a lifesaver in comparison to the other collar. So I would highly, highly, highly recommend you get something similar if you can't find something like that. I'm sure there's a ton of stuff on Amazon, or even your local pet store might have options, but they're not cheap. That one was $45, but it's reusable. It's washable, which were all like important things. And I think most of all, it was just more comfortable for him. If it's something they just have to wear for like a 24-hour period or something, I would say maybe I could have dealt with the, you know, the plastic Elizabethan collar. But surgery was on a Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday, like Thursday, I think I took off from work. Friday, my husband took off from work, and then we were home Saturday, Sunday. So he didn't have to be alone until Monday. So basically 4 days straight of just constant care and watching him and just making sure that he's not rubbing, because even with the Elizabethan collar on, they want to like rub their face and stuff. So I was a complete wreck, but he ended up being okay. And he's, at this point, he's back sort of to normal. He does run into walls a little bit more often. His balance is off. We don't let him go down the stairs, really, only if it's like one or two stairs out to the backyard. So we just keep a really close eye on him. In terms of the financial cost, the surgery, when everything was said and done, was under $1,000 with everything. But in our opinion, it was definitely worth it. I think if it would have been thousands of dollars to have the surgery, we may have opted for a different outcome. But just because of his age, and the fact that, you know, we really didn't know how he's going to do with the anesthesia and make it through surgery. Did we really want to put him through all of that? But he came out just wonderfully. The vet was awesome. She just was so caring and so, you know, kind and understood what we were going through in terms of having to make that decision at that point. And we were just not ready to let him go. So he's doing well. He's walking around. He's eating. He wants his treats. He still, you know, occasionally plays with Elvis, but he's doing well. So we are happy with our decision at this point. We did have to go in after the 2 weeks for her to check the stitches and also then remove them. So they weren't, it wasn't something that was just gonna fall off or heal on their own. So she actually physically had to remove the stitches. And after that, he did not have to wear the Elizabethan collar. So hopefully this was informative for you guys. I don't know if that's something that you're dealing with or have any questions. Make sure to leave me a comment below. I will try to respond to everything. If I left anything out, I will definitely respond. Anyway, I hope this video was informative. If it was, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on my future video, which will be a fashion video. So a completely different and more positive topic for sure. One of my favorites. Anyway, don't forget to subscribe and thanks to you guys for watching. Bye.